if you're new to my channel, my name's Tiana, and if you're returning, it is so nice to see you again. Today we are going to be opening up the Winter Fabfitfun box, and I am so excited and a little sad at the same time because this is going to be my last Fabfitfun box that I'm unboxing because I want to try Cosbox. So I figured I would not renew, try Cosbox for the spring and see how it goes, but this is going to be unboxing the winter box. Let's see if it is worth the money. For Canadians, it can be a little bit more expensive than $50 a month. I think it averages out to about $70. So let's see if it's actually worth it. I know for some of these choices, I said surprise me, and I don't know what I'm getting for everything, and if I don't like it, it'll work out for Christmas gifts. So let's get into unboxing the winter Fabfitfun box. This box I absolutely love because I feel like this is going to make a really nice gift box for presents because the label is underneath. It's very, very pretty, so you could easily put like a big bow or ribbon or something and you could use this to re-gift it. I love that. So, of course, when you open it, everything is laid out so nicely, so I'm really excited to see what's in here. So the first one here, discover the wine you'll love, Bright Cellars. Ooh, this is cool. Take a quiz online. That should be interesting. I don't really drink wine, so it would be cool to see like what they would recommend. The other one here is Dear Self, Today You Will Shine. $15 off your first Fabfitfun box. Oh, that's cool. It's a little postcard. You could give someone $15 off. Here is a HelloFresh card. So you always get some little cards with Fabfitfun. And something we all wait for is the actual book itself. I like to keep these even after the videos and like read through it. So I always like this. So let's pull out an item and see what we got. So I have heard so much hype around this blanket. It is the Unhide blanket. Fluffy, furry, friendly, fresh faux. I love this and it feels really, really soft. This here retails for $65 and in all honesty, it feels really, really nice and soft for the size, for the weight, and for it. You would be paying at least $30 somewhere else anyway. So far this is a really nice addition to the box. And it's a great color for me. If you can't tell, I love gray. The next option I chose was actually the Impressions Vanity Mirror. I really wanted one of these for so, so long, and I'm really excited to give this one a try. You can touch this, it lights up really nicely. It's a really, really nice stand, and to get this in a box, I was actually really, really impressed. Ooh, it comes with batteries, you can charge it, and it's not broken, so that's good. Honestly, great addition to the box. I can't wait to use it. I have been using just like a really big mirror to do my makeup, and it's good, but then when I want to sit and film, I have to move the mirror, so this will be really, really nice and easy, and I can get up close with it. This here retails for $45, and even at a store, you would be paying at least $20+ for this. So already between the blanket and the mirror, the box is already covered, so let's see what I got for number three. But I'm really excited for these because they already feel like great quality items. Honestly, for choice number three, I really couldn't choose what I wanted because none of them really spoke to me. So I let Fabfitfun decide and they chose the Laura Geller Cinnamon and Spice Eyeshadow Palette. I'm gonna be honest, I don't think this palette is going to be for me. Here are the colors. This one's not for me. I think it's a nice size palette, but I feel like I have enough palettes in my collection right now. But I think if you're someone who's into like pinks and shimmers, you would probably like this. So the palette was not for me. That's okay. I had two things I enjoyed. Let's move on to number four. So next up, I chose the Mukluk socks. These here are a size small, medium. Wow, they are soft on the inside. Oh my goodness, I could see myself wearing these a lot. I feel like these are really nice quality. Sometimes when it comes to bigger slipper socks, I feel like if they're not good quality, they get pretty bulky and then the inside and the outside are not like sewn properly together and they get like, I don't know. But these feel really nice. They even have grips on the bottom. So I'm actually really, really excited for these. And I'm going to wear these so much in the winter. I actually bought myself a pair of slippers today. So I'm really excited to have these cozy socks. I know in a store these would at least be $15. So I mean, I'm really stoked to have these and they seem so, so nice and so comfortable. And that leads us to the next one, which I ended up choosing, some cutting boards. So for number five, I chose the Apare cutting boards and you get a set of four. I chose these because I like the fact that there were different colors, they were plastic, and that they had different symbols on them. So for example, this one here is for seafood, you have one for vegetables. So I like the idea of having little symbols on the cutting boards, or at least try to color coordinate. This way, if you want a specific one for fruits or meat or anything like that, you can have them. And I like that they are thin and they are plastic and you can wipe them easy. So I really wanted to have these cutting boards. Even if I don't use them all the time, I feel like they're good as backups. So these here retail for $19.99. I think that is a really good price. And if I were in the store, I could totally see them being $19.99 and paying $19.99 because you get four and they seem good. They're not like too thin, but they're not too thick at the same time. So I am excited to put these with my other cutting boards. This is where I feel like the things kind of went south for me and they just didn't match up at all. Number six, I ended up getting the Below the Belt Croc Card Case. This says $35, I'll be honest. I would not pay $35 for this. And I already use my little Michael Kors passport holder as a wallet already. So this for me, I don't even see myself using. I don't even want to take it out of the package because I know I'm not going to use it. This is a little case that you can put a couple of cards in. You can put some coins in. I'm not really a red person and I'm not really like this kind of like print type of person. And it's just not for me. I feel like it's too small for me and not my thing. So I'm gonna pass this on to someone who may use it more than I would. Number seven is actually a liquid eyeliner. Now, again, I don't think this is going to be something that I'm going to be using. This is from Aesthetica, I believe is how you pronounce it. And it is retailed at $21, which I feel like is a fair amount for an eyeliner. So this eyeliner here, I'm not going to use, and I know I won't because I was watching, I believe it was Jen Love's reviews, and she was saying that the tip on it was like plastic. And for myself personally, I feel like I like a little bit of flexibility with an eyeliner brush because my eyes are small. So this one for me is going to be a pass, but it was nice to get an eyeliner in here. It's just not something that I'm going to use. And let's move into the last option, which I'm probably not gonna use either. Oh, I mixed that up. That was actually supposed to be the last item. This is supposed to be seven, but anyway. So this here is the Daily Concepts Daily Facial Dry Brush. It's for $20. I like the idea of dry brushing, but I feel like my face is a little bit too sensitive for a brush, and I just don't think this is something that I would do enough and I would forget to do. And honestly, if I was going to dry brush or exfoliate, I would want to do my body more than my face. So this I am going to pass along to someone who would probably use it more than I would. I actually have someone in mind that would probably really enjoy using this. But for myself personally, it's just not something that I'm going to use. It has a $20 value, which I do think it would be $20. I'm gonna be honest with you, the last few options that FabFitFun had, I didn't really gravitate towards, so I'm not surprised that they weren't for me. So out of everything in the box that didn't work for me, the first thing is actually the palette. It's just not my color story, and I don't feel like I would use it enough to keep it. I'm not going to use the dry brush. The little wallet, I'm not going to use. I'm going to pass it on. And the eyeliner, it's just not going to be for me. I would prefer something with more of like a felt tip or a pen rather than a little plastic end to work with. So these four for me are no's, unfortunately. But I am still excited for the other items that I did get in the box. It means that my blanket, my cozy socks, the set of cutting boards were my favorite items that I'm going to be keeping. Now, for $70, is this box worth it? I'm saying 70 because that's what it is for Canadians. This box was worth it for me, in my opinion. The blanket, the socks, the cutting boards, and the mirror, if you go to a store, you're not gonna get that for $70. The four additional products that are going to be gifted probably for Christmas are additional Christmas gifts that I don't have to pay for right now. So honestly, I really did enjoy this box. The only thing I felt with FabFitFun lately is there's a lot of categories that I struggle with picking items, and then I start to receive a lot of items that I don't need. And the reason why I want to try Cosbox is because it feels a little bit more curated. So I want to try Cosbox. If I don't enjoy Cosbox, I'll probably come back to FabFitFun because I do enjoy the subscription box. And I think you get really, really great things. I mean, I use many things from FabFitFun and I'm really excited to use these things from FabFitFun. Let me know in the comments down below what you got from FabFitFun or what your favorite thing from this box was. Or let me know if you've ever tried Cosbox before. Make sure to subscribe if you have not, or ring the bell to be notified when I upload next. And I will see you all in the next one. Bye.